from WXII 12 Sports. This is the Wake Zone with Chris Lee.
All right, welcome back to the Wake Zone. Before we get started and I introduce everybody here, I want to say a quick shout out to our man Dave Gorn. He was supposed to join us tonight, but he's dealing with some family stuff, and hope everything gets well. Hopefully everybody out there will send him some well wishes as well on Twitter. Just reach out to him, say I hope everything is going well. But I am being joined by Stan Cotten, the voice of the Demon Deacons, also Ty Collins. How are you doing today, sir? What should I introduce you as?
You could say the voice of the soccer teams. I don't know.
The voice of the soccer team. You can hear him on the call for Wake Forest soccer, men's soccer teams. He does a great job. And also Carolina Cobras, so he definitely knows his football. All right, the Deeks are back from a bye, so of course that means we're back from a bye. We're ready to jump into the latest storyline surrounding this team. You guys ready to do this?
Let's go.
Ready.
Right,
let's go.
Let's check it out. Of course, two Saturdays ago, our Wake Forest Demon Deacons had a close game against the Florida State Seminoles at home. This one ended up allowing the Deacs to become bowl eligible. They beat them 22-20. Sam Hartman started in the place of Jamie Newman. He threw for over 300 yards in this one. And so that was good. The Deacs also had last weekend off, which was their second bye of the season. Head coach Dave Clawson has been very open about his team's struggles over his time with Wake Forest coming off of a bye. Under Clawson, Wake Forest is 0-6. After a week off. That includes losing to Louisville a few weeks ago at home. Coach also talked about overcoming those struggles to head into this weekend's matchup this morning at his weekly press conference.
Like, we do off-season research and that stuff, and I mean, you know, if you don't give up two long kickoffs and a punt return, it's a non-issue. So, you know, we're preparing to play NC State. You know, we've played well here in openers. We've played well in bowl games. You know, our preparation, it is what it is. Now we have to go out there and play well and execute well.
You have to do the same exact thing every single week and go 1-0 each week. That's a really hard thing to do. And that's our process this week, to go 1-0.
What are you doing? All right, guys, they are 0-6 after a bye under Dave Clawson. What do you think they're going to do?
After you, Stan.
Well, I mean, you talk about this week.
This week, yes.
Time will tell. I mean, I can promise you this, that Dave Clawson and his staff have turned over every rock, every pebble, every page to find a way to get off the schneid and win a game after a bye week. In the old days, we called it the open date. But I think it's one of those weird stats that's just that. It's weird. I don't think they're doing anything wrong.
Yeah.
But it's still, you're toasting a bagel there, right? You got the offer going, and they'd love to win one, just so we'll talk about something else.
Hey, he did mention that they're fine on bowl games. You know, there's like 4 weeks in between the end of the season and the bowl games. They're fine at the beginning of the season, just that those bye weeks are kind of tough. What do you say, Ty?
I'd much rather have that case than having the other way of just losing in the bowl game as opposed to having the bye problem. I mean, remember, Andy Reid had the same issue, right? And Andy Reid is a pretty successful coach, right?
Very good
Just
point.
Saying.
That's a very good point. This weekend, Wake Forest will host NC State. But over the last couple of years, Wake Forest has won their in-state challenges dating back to their win over NC State last year. The Deacs have defeated all other ACC schools, also Elon. So take a look at it. This is it right here. They'll look to continue that streak this weekend against NC State. We're back with our panel. These guys have played this game 109 years in a row, 113 times overall. Wake Forest has had NC State's number, however, the last two seasons. Both times NC State was the favorite team, and also both times NC State was ranked. Now the tables have turned. Wake Forest is ranked. Wake Forest is the favorite team. NC State is the underdog. Wolfpack head coach Dave Doran spoke about this at his weekly press conference.
Yeah, I mean, they are the ranked team. You know, I mean, record-wise, them and Clemson have the best records in the league, you know. So our players know what's going on out there. Some of our guys were part of those games, but not many, you know. So I don't know how much I can lean on that and have anything come out of it. You know, to me, it's more about, regardless of who we play, it's going to be how we play. And I think that's the thing with our football team right now. Not that I don't care who we play. I do, obviously. But I care a lot more about how we play as a football team right now. And if we just get better, you know, and make the plays that we can make and do the things that we can do, then we'll be in every game and have a chance to win. And, you know, hopefully at quarterback, Devin continues to get better and better and make those plays that he showed us in the fourth quarter last week. And that'll help our offense.
All right, guys, so should Wake Forest be concerned that the tables have potentially turned? You have a hungry underdog team looking to get an upset win this weekend.
You know, I don't know. I've been thinking about this some this afternoon. You know, last week or last year, Wake goes into those last 3 weeks at, 4-5. Mm-hmm. You know, and it was later in the season than it is right now. You look at NC State right now, I mean, this is a team that's 4-3 with 5 weeks to go. Three of their remaining games are in Raleigh, and one of the road games is at Georgia Tech, and, you know, the Yellow Jackets are struggling more than anybody else in the league. So, you know, last year, Wake had to win two of those last three to get to a bowl, and ended up having to win against two bowl teams, NC State and Duke, away from Winston-Salem. So I don't think the situations are exactly the same.
The backs aren't against the wall, just like Wake Forest.
Yeah, I mean, the 5 weeks to go, and State's already won four games, and they have a winning record, the Wolfpack does. So I don't think the situations are really comparable, but, you know, you just win a couple more games, you're fine, but you got a long way to do it, a long stretch to get it done.
What do you think is happening, Ty?
I think with NC State, they have a winning season. But in NC State land, Wolfpack land, they want more, and so I think they are going to be gunning actually for a win, and their backs are against the wall, so that's why you see the brand new quarterback. They want to throw everything at Wake Forest. They understand the last two losses to them. They understand the rivalry and how it has not gone well for them, especially in Winston-Salem. So here I think you have a wounded animal, and I think they're going to come out with nothing to lose, and that's scary if you're a coach.
Yeah.
Because you know, you're ranked, you're trying to protect your ranking and not thinking about someone winning. And then you got a team that's hungry. That's a scary situation. But Wake Forest, I think they'll be ready for this one.
You said wounded. There is some bad news coming from that Florida State game that, you know, could be something bad for Wake Forest this coming weekend. Of course, Justin Sternad, he got injured in this past game. He ruptured his bicep. Could have an impact on Wake Forest, and here Dave Clawson talked about that earlier this morning as well.
But it's one of those things that collectively everybody's going to have to step their game up, and we've got to do a great job communicating. You know, Justin was kind of the leader in terms of the checks and getting everybody on the same page, and now, you know, Ryan Smenda is going to have to do a much better job with that, and he will. I think when you have someone like Justin, there's a tendency to rely on that person because he's so good at it and he's so confident in it. And Ryan is getting to the point now that he's played a lot of football and he's more than capable of doing those things for us.
So, Stan, you watch these guys every single week. Of course, Coach just mentioned some guys that he thinks that should pick up production. What do you see out there? Who do you think should pick up that production now that Sternad is out for the season?
Well, I think it's unfair to tap any player on the shoulder and say, hey, Ryan Smenda, you got to be Justin Sternad. Jaquez Williams, you got to be Sternad. Travion Red, no, it's you. They're not going to replace Justin Sternad. I mean, going in the last couple of weeks, he was the ACC's leading tackler.
Right.
He's a captain, fifth-year guy. You don't replace players like that. But I think what Coach Clawson said there rings true. You have to take all those players I mentioned and say, fellas, you got to play a little bit better. You know, we got to, you know, do what we do and don't make mistakes. And it's kind of next guy up mentality. Wake's got enough depth at linebacker where last year they got down to one.
Yeah.
You know, it's not that way this year. Some younger players, but I think they'll be fine. But you don't replace a guy like Justin Sternad with one player. You just don't do it.
It's tough, especially when he led the ACC in tackles at one point.
He was one of the better players in this league.
69 tackles total so far this year. What do you say, Ty?
I like Jaquez Williams. I think he's done a great job coming in. The way he played it against Florida State. So, you know, it's like Stan said, next guy up. And, I mean, they ran into this problem last year, and they seemed to rise to the occasion. They made their run to the bowl, so.
It's true. Well, this week can also be a little bit of a reunion, of course. Former Wake Forest wide receiver Tabari Hines, he transferred from Wake Forest, went to Oregon, and then he came back to North Carolina. He went to NC State, and head coach Dave Doran at NC State talked about that reunion earlier at his press conference yesterday.
We talked to Tabari about it, you know, and his answer was great. He said, I can't think about it that way. I got to be the best me for this football game, and you can't get hung up in what it was there. I mean, it's hard not to have personal feelings about playing at the school you were at, you know. But he was very quick to say that, you know, it's not about that. It's about playing for these guys here. And so we'll see where that goes. But that's the comments he made.
All right, so is this the perfect setup for Tabari Hines to come back and just have the best day ever?
Oh, man, I hope not.
In his career at Wake Forest at BB&T Field.
I hope not. I mean, we love Tabari. He had a great career at Wake, but I hope he's fine. And just he's done with great plays at Wake Forest just for a week.
Yeah, just for a week.
Hope he plays okay, not great.
Yeah.
I've always been a Tabari Hines fan. I thought he would flourish in this offense if he stayed, especially with the combo of Greg Dortch. Unfortunately, he decided to go elsewhere. I hate seeing him coming back with a different uniform, but he is a dangerous weapon. I call him like a Lamborghini. When you had two Lamborghinis on the field with Greg Dortch and him, they caused a lot of problems. So I know this is sticking in the back of his mind that he wants to pay back the Deacons. Still, I got a soft spot for him because I just love the speedy receivers. But I don't know. NC State's got a lot of injuries, so they're going to be looking at, and they got a brand new quarterback. So
that's true.
We'll see how that chemistry plays, right?
Devin Leary, Tabari, maybe they're not on the same page yet, so it still could bode well for Wake Forest. Now, Stan, you're actually calling the game, so I'm going to skip over you.
Thank you.
On this one,
okay.
But Ty Collins, what do you think?
Bring the keys in the game. Okay.
I want to ask you about your score prediction for this coming Saturday. What do you think is going to happen?
Oh, man. NC State, Wake Forest, always a rivalry. I think some are giving Wake Forest a little too much credit and pushing them to what, touchdown favored. I think it'll be closer than that. I think, say, 6. But Wake Forest wakes up, beats NC State. They start exploiting the injuries, especially in the secondary with NC State. I think 9 out of 22 players were injured versus Boston College. So they know that, and they see they smell the blood in the water. And when you've got some players like Kendall Hinton and, of course, Sage Surratt, tell them, Stan, you know what they can do.
You know. So what did you say the score
was going to be? I'm going to just say, just be safe. I'll say 2 field goals.
2 field goals.
Yeah.
So something 6. Like a 30 to 24 type of thing.
I think a lot of people thinking 7 plus. I'm going to go just conservatively at 6.
Okay.
And then another exciting game, just because NC State, they bring the ruckus. I mean, they can bring their fan base.
Sure can.
You promise you the Deacs will take 6 right now and run with it. They'll tell you. They'll tell you.
Yeah, they sure will. Stan, we have to leave you out of this. I do think around what you're thinking, Ty, but I'm thinking a little bit more high of a scoring game. I don't know if NC State can keep up with Wake Forest on the scoring department. So I think if Wake Forest hits 30, they definitely win. So I'm thinking more so in like the 38 to 32 range, something like
that.
I'll go
with that.
Also, I got some scores from other guys. I forgot to put those scores in so you guys could see that here. But Les Johns, he says 31 to 21, Wake Forest.
Okay.
And Connor O'Neill, he said, I forgot his actual score, but it was something like 24 to 21, NC State. So
Connor said that.
NC State. So we'll see. But I want to ask you guys this before we get off. What are the keys to a Wake Forest victory? What does Wake Forest have to do to actually get this win, get their 7th win of the season this Saturday?
Well, not to sound like a coach, but they really got to shore up their kicking game. You know, they had a couple of breakdowns in the Florida State
Very
game
true.
That Coach Clawson mentioned. And I think they'll be fine there. I really just think they need to play Wake Forest football, and that has been this season. Very few mistakes. They don't commit many penalties. They don't turn the ball over. Mm-hmm. And if they can handle those situations, they're at home. Crowd's going to be good. It's going to be great weather, according to Laney Pope. So I think they'll be fine. I really do. But they just need to play like they have been playing all season long, and they should be okay.
All right, 1 minute left. What are the keys to the victory for Wake Forest? What do they have to do to get this win?
To touch back on what Stan said, I think Wake Forest just needs to focus on it's a football game, not worry about rankings. They go after the secondary, pass, run, balance attack, but then use Jack Frudenthal and use Kendall Hinton. Use those slot receivers. I thought it worked great. I think they kind of shied away from it. Mm-hmm. Use that, and I think they'll be just fine.
Oh, we'll say this. Coach Clawson did say that this morning if Jamie Newman was good enough to go on Saturday, he would go. If not, it's going to be Sam Hartman. So it sounds like he's leaning towards Jamie Newman, of course, but it's just going to be all dependent on health. And Christian Bill Smith will not play this Saturday as well. So we're going to see what happens. Kickoff is at noon at BB&T Field this Saturday in Winston-Salem. Thank you, Stan. Thank you, Ty, for joining me. You're watching The Wake Zone right here on the WXI 12 Facebook page. We'll see you again next week.